Your first tournament's coming up and you're shitting a brick. I completely understand the scenario. I had my first actual varsity tournament when I was a sophomore, and there were a bunch of things that I wish I knew before I got into this tournament. I was completely clueless, terrible at listening. So, first things first, before you go to a tournament, if you don't already know this is a huge part of American wrestling. You have to weigh in to a specific weight class. You must weigh in beneath that weight class. So if the weight class is 145, you must weigh in 145 pounds or below that in order to be in that weight class. And you can't be no more than two weight classes below. So you can't be a 106 pounder wrestling 138, because that wouldn't work. And basically what cutting weight is people diet and lose weight throughout the week so that they can lower the weight class that they're in so that they're bigger and stronger than the competition. Sounds really backwards. People stop drinking, they run, they sweat. This is probably one of the most difficult aspects of wrestling, but it is like a huge part of it. A huge, huge part of it. I have a ton of other videos. Check them out if you haven't seen them, if you don't know about cutting weight. But next is weighing in, all right? So the first day of a tournament, I'm talking big boy tournaments, like tournaments with like 16, 32 man brackets. You line up with your team. That means when you walk into the tournament, you're gonna put all your stuff on the bleachers. People are gonna be warming up and wrestling. And then before you weigh in, you're gonna line up with your team. And most of the time they make you get into your singlet or your underwear. They check your skin and they check your fingernails. You have to clip your fingernails, make sure your skin's good. Shave that day if you have to shave. Make sure your hair is not too long, or they do the full check. And then they'll call you team by team, right? Because you lined up by team, into the locker room. And you guys weigh in, right? It's usually two or three teams at a time, depending on like how many scales they have. So you'll weigh in and then like you just walk outside, you put your clothes on, you go in the bleachers and you wait. You wait up until they call either your weight class or your name, right? I've had both happen at tournaments where like you're waiting and they call like Isaac Gomez to the stand and like you run up. Those are usually the smaller tournaments. And then at other tournaments, they'll call the whole weight class. They'll call like the 138 weight class, the 145 weight class. And you go up with your weight class, you're waiting for your name to get called. As soon as they call your name, they hand you a card and they'll call your opponent's name. They'll hand you a card and they'll say, go to mat three, right? All the mats have tables and they're labeled, right? It'll say mat one, mat two, mat three, mat four. It's usually clockwise. So you go to that mat. Unless you're a lightweight, you're not gonna be the first person, like you're not gonna hand in your card and you're gonna start wrestling, right? That's only really for like 106 pounders, or the tournament starts at like a weird weight. So you're gonna hand in your card. Unless you're the first person wrestling, there's gonna be people wrestling before you. So you're gonna have to wait two or three matches, right? You don't go back to the stand, unless you have like five or six matches in front of you, don't go back to the stands, wait there. Just warm up, get in the right mindset, get a little sweat going. Be prepared, remember the things that you learned, single legs, double legs, setups, everything that you learned. Now, when they call your name, the first thing you need to do is step your feet into the mat cleaner, the bleach or whatever they have, wipe them, and then you go to the table, you tell them your name, they confirm, and then you run to the center of your circle. The ref will tell you what color bracelet you need to wear and you need to put it on. You can either stand around or you can wait lined up for your opponent if you're not the first one there. Don't be late to this. You wanna make this as quick and smooth of a process as possible, because to the coaches and refs, it's not as big of a deal as it is to you. You know what I mean? And they're just trying to like get through the matches. Don't be late. Don't be like lazy. Pay attention to which matches are ahead of you. Like warm up. I wouldn't suggest staring down your opponent, because it doesn't really intimidate. Like it never intimidated me. It just made me think like, all right, this dude's trying to scare me because he doesn't know how to wrestle. Like that's what I thought in the later years. After you're lined up and they like start the match, they always start the match in neutral. And then the second period is a coin flip. And then the third period is the other person's choice. You should already know that, but I'm just reinstating that. So yeah, that's everything I wish I knew. Like if you make it to the second day of a tournament, then you weigh in by weight class, you line up by weight class, not by school, because not everyone from every school makes it. So it's gonna be like 138, 145, 152, all lines up together. All right, so if you like that video, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. But until next time, I'll see you guys. Peace.